terrorists bring war.
The number of refugees by the end of 2000.
ISIS will be a big issue.
There's just so much going on globally. There's so much bad news.
Markets around the world plunged.
And whether it's Brexit or terrorism or some major tragedy, it kind of knocks what's happening in Africa off the front page.
The media deals in images, and understandably the biggest images at the moment for most of us are boat people coming from parts of Africa or Turkey and the tragic images coming out of Aleppo. But that doesn't mean that the African story has somehow been forgotten.
It used to be more at the forefront of our thinking, but sadly the problems haven't gone away, the need hasn't gone away.
Foreign aid target has been condemned as a con job.
I think it's very easy for people in the West to be very cynical about the impact that NGOs can have. But it is a fact that the work of international development organisations has made a strong impact over the years. The number of people living in absolute poverty in the world has gone from 1.9 billion in 1990 to 836 million in 2015. If you read the newspapers, you wouldn't know that.
This is such a great opportunity to remind ourselves of the incredible difference that all of us can make here tonight in impacting lives where there is still enormous need and even relatively small amounts of resources, if they're properly placed, can make such a difference.
As far as the work of ACE Africa in particular is concerned, when we did our baseline research in Bungoma in Kenya in 2003, HIV prevalence was 30%. Right now, it's 3%. It's important to know that that work is effective and has led to a significant positive change in people's lives.
ACE Africa has grown considerably over the years,
but its core values are still the same. It's still trying to resolve issues that are ultimately related to massive HIV problems in the communities that it serves. It goes and finds new communities and new remote areas that through extensive research require attention. It doesn't just have a sort of a quick fix or a set format that it just applies to these different communities.
It's the absolute starting part of every ACE programme is really, really in-depth research as to what the needs are. And it's not about going in and having a kind of one-size-fits-all plan as to what a community might need, because each community, as we all know, is very different.
This is not a situation where direct aid comes in and out, and occasionally. When they commit to a project, they are there for the long run, and I think this can make a huge difference. They want to stay there in communities for 10 or 15 years.
What's special about ACE is that you care about the whole person, so it's making sure that everybody's livelihoods, health care, nutrition and everything is set up so that that ownership of a better life can be adopted by the communities that you deal with.
Non-governmental organisations like ACE are a lifeline for the community. The government is the main provider of health, but there are some things the government won't do. The government won't be able to follow up a patient who is lost to treatment and encourage them to go and get treated. But those are the kind of things that organizations like ACE do.
I personally think it's a wonderful thing that the founders, even after 12 years, are still very much involved. In fact, they still lead the organization.
The most important thing for us is, can we see the intervention? And we feel that the effectiveness, therefore, has been proven by Jo and her team. For us, that is the most important thing.
If I'm going to support with time and fundraising, my primary concern is that it's going to be effective and that it's needed. And ACE certainly fits into both those camps.
It's not until you get out there and you really see what living on less than a dollar a day really means. It's not until you see the kids who have to walk 10 kilometres to school without any shoes on every day, and then when they're in school having nothing to eat all day, nothing at all, that you really understand what the statistics and the reports that you've been reading back in the office mean.
The purpose of the trip was to set up a football programme in some rural schools just outside of Arusha, and it would mean the children would stop being truant and they would turn up to school just so they got this chance to play football.
The thing that really touched my dad was what they call the C2C program, the child-to-child program, where the team in Ace Africa are teaching kids at a really young age what their rights are. You're seeing children starting to understand exactly what they're entitled to.
We were really impressed because we could see the effectiveness of areas like the community garden, microfinance. The scope of what ACE does was also impressive. So the emphasis on FGM, which is a pretty troubled issue to address in certain Maasai communities, but the ACE team were doing it with sensitivity through drama programs, and my son and I were very impressed.
We visited many different communities, from people who were working with goats to sustainable farming, even one lady who literally just had a sack to feed her family. But she'd been given the seeds, she'd been given the know-how and the knowledge, and the impact is just incredible. It's really heartwarming to see it.
If you're considering supporting ACE, and I hope you would be, the real thing you should think about is what it means to change the life of an individual. Change that person's life to being educated, earning enough income to do what they want to do, and to belonging to a community which is sufficiently well organized that the whole community is advancing. You're not changing it just for the 12 years as ACE is there, you're changing it for that person's life, and as far as the community is concerned, forever.